Hello, in this video, I will explain you and show you how you can create SAS Viya Jobs with a prompt using the task prompt in SAS Viya 3.5. I will first explain you what are SAS Viya Jobs, what are the differences between SAS Viya 3.4 and 3.5 in terms of developing SAS Viya Jobs, and I will also explain you what are task prompts. At the last step, I will show you how you can use SAS Studio to create SAS Viya Jobs using the task prompt. SAS Viya Jobs provide the same functionalities or similar functionalities to SAS 9 store processes. They execute through HTTP requests, calling the SAS Job Execution web application. They are executing on the SAS compute server, compared to the SAS store process server in SAS 9, and they are launched through the SAS launcher server, which is an equivalent to SAS object spawner. If you are familiar to SAS 9 store processes, you should remember that we were using STP begin and STP end autocall macros. For SAS Viya Jobs, we will be using GES begin and GES end autocall macros. SAS Viya Jobs are based on different components. We can define job forms. We have a job definition. We have also job parameters and job prompts. The job prompts are new in Viya 3.5, and this is the topic of this session. What are the main differences between Viya 3.4 and 3.5 in terms of SAS Viya Jobs? We have now the job and task prompt. Task prompts are not new to SAS Viya. They were available in SAS Studio earlier release. It was giving the opportunity to the users to define their own prompts for the task in SAS Studio. Compared to SAS Viya 3.4, the preferred editor for SAS Viya Job is now the SAS Studio 5. In earlier releases, you were supposed to use the SAS Job Execution web application to develop your SAS code and your Viya Jobs. We have now within SAS Studio specific menu options, as you can see here below, where you create a new job, you have the option to create a definition, an HTML form, and a task prompt. You have also specific panes within SAS Studio, as you can see here on the right-hand side, where you have the opportunity to assign a form to the job, to define the job properties, and also define the job parameters. What are task prompts? So they were introduced in SAS Viya 3.5. They are based on Common Task Model, also known as CTM. It's an XML-based model used to define custom tasks in SAS Studio. This is not only to define the prompts for the Viya Jobs, but also your own task that you want to build. The basic structure of the task prompt is, as you can see below here, you need to define a task. You have a registration section, a metadata section, UI section, and also option dependencies. Of course, you can find information on the web in the user's guide, but I will show you what you can do in a little demo. So we are now in SAS Studio. We will create a new job, a new job definition. You see that you are getting the editor as a program editor that we are used to have in SAS Studio. First, what I will do here is copy paste the SAS code that we will use, because I don't want to show you that I cannot really type quickly. I will really use the copy paste. So what is this option doing, code doing? It's defining some macro variables for the statements that we will use. We have a macro called generate, which will define for each variable the code that is used for the wear clause, and the wear clause is used over here for a proc print. So you see that we have origin statement. If we have var origin defined, we have an origin statement, and for the type statement, for the drive statement, and invoice statement. As you can see here, we are using the SAS help cars. You can use whichever data set you want to use. For the sake of this demonstration, SAS help cars is more than enough. What I will do is show you how you can define a prompt. So here you have the associated form. You can use HTML forms so that you are building an external HTML form. You can use task prompt, or you can use an existing form. We will select the task prompt. Again, I will not type everything, but because I don't want to show you that I'm not really quick at typing, I will just explain you what we have done within the job and the task definition. As you can see, we are defining an XML file. We have a task with a specific schema. Then we have the registration section. In the registration section, we give a name to the prompt that we are defining. In this case, filter cars, because we are filtering the SAS help cars. Give a nice description, prompt for SAS help cars report in this case, and a version. For the version, we recommend to use the SAS Studio version that you are using, so that you know which functionalities are available at the time you developed the prompt. The second section will be the metadata. In the metadata, we will define a data source. So the data source we define that is a data set. That's the name of our data source. The default value U will be SAS help cars. Then we have nowhere clause. The data source is required and it's read-only. You will see that the fact that it's read-only, you will not be able to update the or to change the data source within the prompt. If you want, you can change that and adapt it to your needs. Then we will define some filters on the data source, and each filter will have a name. So we have a filter named origin filter, which will filter the origin column. And we will sort by label, ascending direction. We define a type filter on the column type, also sorted by the labels and in ascending order. But there we will say that the type variable will be will be filtered by a where clause, and the where clause is using an expression. The expression is equal, and it's using the origin column and filtering based on the var origin. So when we will define here the filter, it will create a var origin that we have defined in our code as a macro variable. And it will be used over here to filter the data in the type. The same will be done with the drivetrain. You have the drivetrain filter based on the column drivetrain. In this case, we will use the in operator on the column type, and we will retrieve the information from var type that we have defined also in our code. Then we have some options that we will be defining. What are options? Basically, the options are the components that you will see in your user interface or in your prompt. So you will have to define each of them in the options, and then you will define and arrange the layout using the UI component. So In this case, we will have an option called filter tab. It's with a label filtering. We have a geo group option named and that will display geography. We have var origin, and the var origin is a combo box. It's using the origin filter, and it has a default value of Asia. We have the required set to true, and missing message that you can define, please select an origin. We have characteristic group, so we will see that in our UI we have a specific group that's called characteristic, and car's characteristics is the label. Then we have var type. We are using the filter var type filter. It's a select box. We have drivetrain, using the drivetrain filter, and it's a combo box. You define the label that you want to see. And then we have a financial group, which will be grouping the financial information. And in this case, the financial information is a slider with a default value of 50,000, minimum value 10,000, and discrete values equal 10, max value being 100,000. You have also a prompt message and a label for that. If we move now to the UI, so this is where we will define the layout of the prompt. We define a container, and the container is based on option called filter tab that we have defined over here. And the label is filtering. Within that container, we have a data item called dataset. So this is basically the prompt for the dataset selection. In our case, there is not really a prompt. It's just showing that we have selected SAS help cars. Then we have a group, and the group is called geogroup. It will be labeled geography. It's open by default. And we have option choice and var origin within that group. We have another group called characteristic groups. It's open by default and it has different options. As you can see here, we are just defining the option choice and not more than that. The definition of each option is defined in the options metadata. So as mentioned earlier, this is only the layout of your prompt that we are seeing over here. Then we have the financial group. It's open by default. And then we have finally the option dependencies. What are option dependencies? It's defining what should be displayed and when. So you can have kind of conditional prompts where, for example, when var origin will be set to Asia, we will show the financial group that we have defined over here. If not, the financial group will not be displayed. It's no time to save our job definition. So click the save button, go to SAS content. In this case, I will save it under gel jobs, and I will call cars prompt demo. Save it. As soon as I save, I can execute the code, press run, and you see here that we have now the interface, the prompt. We see that we have the SAS help cars selected. We see that the geography is set by default to Asia. I can expand or collapse all the groups. You see that here I have Asia and I see the financial aspects. So as we mentioned in earlier, thanks to the trigger option, the option dependency. You can see, hide or display some groups. Then I selected Europe. Within Europe, it's a dynamic selection. So I have SUV, sedan, sport, and wagon. If I go to the US, I will have another selection, which adds truck. You see that here, I'm not able to select it. So I will go to sedan. And I have all front and rear. While if I go for trucks, I have only all and rear. As soon as I've made my selection, I will press the submit button and it will execute the code and display the report. This is the end of the demo. If you need more information about SAS Viya Jobs, you can have a look at the user's guide for the job web execution application. You can also have a look at the developer's guides to writing custom tasks in SAS Studio 5.2. And if you need more information about the infrastructure, you can have a look at compute server and launcher server information that are available within the online documentation. Thank you, and check back with Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.